Hello, ladies and gentlemen and fellow gamers. My name is GamerLCD, and I finally got a haircut. Today, we're going to be discussing a video game that hasn't been on the radar for quite some time now. Now, this game was first announced back in December of 2011, and the game that I'm referring to is Fortnite. Now, Fortnite is an unreleased game that is still in development, but a lot of people don't even know that it exists, or even know that it was announced, or, you know, still in development, because there hasn't been any new information about this game since it was first announced 2.5 years ago. So, what I'm going to be doing in this video is discussing this game, you know, giving you guys the full details about what we know so far. Is it still in development? Was it canceled? And if it's still in development, when can we see this game? So if you guys are interested, go ahead and stay tuned, and we'll be right back.
Put the camera down, man. It's showtime.
All right, clear! Grab what you can!
Hey, we got some good stuff, man.
Hurry up and help me get this off, man.
So to start off, Fortnite is being created by the people who brought you Gears of War and the Unreal Engine and the Unreal Tournament series. And these people, of course, are Epic Games. Now, what's important to note about Fortnite is that it is the first game that's being developed on the brand new Unreal Engine 4, Epic Games' new next-gen 3D engine. It is also going to be strictly for PC. When they first announced this game 2.5 years ago, they had no mention of consoles, yet they did say that their focus is making this first and foremost a PC game, and maybe later on it could come to consoles. And that's probably part of the reason why we haven't heard anything about this game, is because when they first announced it, they said PC, PC, PC for this game. But, you know, the delay for 2.5 years where we've heard nothing about it could mean that they're also trying to develop it for consoles as well, using Unreal Engine 4. So since Xbox One and PlayStation 4 weren't out in 2011, they probably wanted to wait a little bit, or maybe, you know, since they're finally out, now they can actually develop it for consoles and release it at the same time as PC. So there's one theory. Now, also, the whole point around this game is that it's going to be a co-op sandbox, you know, survival game. And this has really piqued my interest when it was first announced, is because I'm really into these, you know, castle defender games that revolve around, you know, playing with friends, you know, fighting off waves of zombies and monsters or whatever. And that really appeals to me because it's a really fun way, you know, to keep playing the game. You know, with these literally linear storyline games, once you beat the single player campaign, it's over. It doesn't really offer any replay value. But with these co-op sandbox games, they offer a ton of replay value because the game is always different. The game is always changing. There's always a bunch of new levels and campaigns and a bunch of new, you know, story modes and things like that. Now, one thing I wanted to mention is that this game is very, very similar to a really popular game that I had a lot of fun with, and that is, of course, Monster Madness Battle for Suburbia. As you guys can see, I have the Games for Windows version, which is obviously the superior version to the console. The online is basically dead at this point, but the single player is very, very enjoyable, and you can try that out. You can probably get this on eBay or GameStop for like maybe $2. That's how cheap it is right now. The online is dead, so don't try to, you know, play this online, but the game is very, very solid. It's got pretty much the same concept as what they're doing for with Fortnite. Now, of course, I'm not going to sit here and talk about Monster Madness forever. If you guys want to learn more about that game, you can, you know, go look it up online or something like that. It's a very awesome game that was overlooked by a lot of people. And I really don't know why, because it was an amazing game. But moving on to Fortnite again, Fortnite, like I said, it's going to be like a defender game. It's, you got, you know, co-op up to four people, maybe even eight, depending on if there's online support. We don't know about that yet. There's very little details about this game, I will say. And that is because, you know, there hasn't been any new information released since its first reveal in December of 2011. So two years ago, there hasn't been a single piece of information that they've released thus far. All we know basically is that it's going to be a co-op survival game that revolves around zombies and building structures and things like that. Now, this isn't your ordinary, you know, castle defender game. You're actually going to be involved with defending whatever you're trying to defend. So you actually have to build walls. You have to build these things. We're talking about Epic Games here. So take Gears of War, for example. In the new Gears of War 3 or Gears of War Judgment, they added a way. They added Horde mode, which is a way for you to build structures, you know, build different weapons and upgrades and things like that. Take that, for example, in Fortnite. That's what you're going to be able to be doing. Players can build and edit each wall of their fort with a 3x3 grid. You know, they can lay down stairs, they can lay down roofs, windows, sculpt them. To fit their particular structure. So you'll be able to edit, you know, your wall, you'll be able to edit your roof. We're not saying this is going to be a house or anything like that. This is going to be a gigantic structure. And these pictures that I'm going to be showing you guys have been showing you guys throughout this video, and even the trailer at the beginning, it shows you a little bit about what this game is going to be about. Now, that's pretty much everything. Everything I just discussed is everything that we know about the game. It's a co-op sandbox game. It's survival. It's kind of like a castle defender game. You're going to be able to build your own structures and forts and things like that, and, you know, survive waves of monsters and zombies. Now, there is no information on whether or not this is going to be like an open world type game and you're able to move freely around and things like that, because that's what Monster Madness is. It's about, you know, going through this linear storyline. It's co-op, of course, so you have each character that has different weapon sets, and you're killing zombies, moving on to the next area, killing zombies, moving on. That's not going to be what Fortnite is. It's going to be a survival game, which means that you're probably going to go from wave to wave to wave. I don't think you're going to be able to move your character around or do, you know, any of that crazy stuff that you can do in Monster Madness, but it's still going to be fun nonetheless. Now, keep in mind that this game is being built on Unreal Engine 4, which is probably why the game has been in the development as long as it has, and why we haven't seen any or heard any new information about it since it was first announced. Unreal Engine 4 is a very, very powerful engine, and it's one of those things that takes a while to create. You know, on previous engines for Xbox 360 and PlayStation 3, a game maybe took a year, year and a half to create. But with these new next-gen consoles, and especially with these new next-gen engines such as Unreal Engine 4, we're looking at video games that are going to be taking 3 to 4 years to create. Not to mention all, you know, the logistics that go along with releasing a video game, such as creating all the box art, all the discs, and all things like that. You know, doing all the paperwork, yada, 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 releasing in the game stores. And so, you know, as we progress through years and years and years and the technology gets better and better, we're going to be seeing longer and longer time frames for video games. Not only video games, perhaps movies as well. We just don't know, because the technology is always getting better, which means that, you know, they're supposed to make things faster. But, you know, as the engines progress, it just means more and more time for developers to work with them. So that's all I really wanted to talk about in this video, guys, was, of course, Fortnite. Now, why should you be hyped for this game? Now, that's one of the things I was going to talk about. Now, why you should be hyped for this game is because, number one, it's going to be on PC. Number two, well, I guess it could be on consoles as well, but we just don't know. Number two, it's being built on Unreal Engine 4. This is the very first game ever that's going to be released on Unreal Engine 4, or being built on Unreal Engine 4. And if you guys haven't seen Unreal Engine 4 yet, I encourage you to do so. You can probably find a video anywhere on YouTube or any website for now. Just go to Bing and type in Unreal Engine 4, and they'll get a tons and tons of videos showing it off. It's gonna look really, really nice. Now, this game is cartoony, so you're not gonna get, you know, the full realism effect of it, but, you know, you still got all the main structures of Unreal Engine 4 with this game. You also have other games coming out with Unreal Engine 4, such as, you know, Fable Legends, which is being built for Xbox One on Unreal Engine 4. So that's something to look forward to as well. Now, we are in a brand new console generation, so seeing games on next-gen engines is not something we're going to see every other month. It's probably going to be every couple of years that we see, you know, one of these amazing games. Like I said earlier, games are going to take longer and longer to make. So hope you guys enjoyed the pictures and the videos that I had throughout this video. Hope you're very, very excited for Fortnite. Now, when can we expect this game? Now, the current release date for Fortnite is for 2014. So there is no specific date. We'll probably hear more about it at E3, if not before. Like I said, this game has been in development for over, I would say, almost 5 years now. Maybe a little less than that. But so this game probably has to be very, very far along, and they're just waiting for the right moment to announce all the new juicy details about this game. So the fact that we haven't heard a single thing about it doesn't mean that the game is dead. It just means that they're, you know, working really, really hard, or they're doing some really massive internal restructuring. Like I said earlier, their main intent was to put this on PC, but that could also mean that they're, you know, putting in that extra work to put it on Xbox One and PlayStation 4, because this is one of those games that'll be really, really console friendly, especially since it's like a co-op survival game. Those are really, really hot titles on consoles. Take Diablo 3, for example. When they released Diablo 3 on consoles, it was a very, very strong sales because people like the aspect of being able to sit down with their friends, you know, log into the game and kill some zombies for maybe 10, 15 minutes, and you'll be able to get off. It's just something fun to do to kill some extra time. And that's why, you know, co-op games, survival games like that, do very, very well on console. So if I was Epic Games, I would release this on Xbox One and PlayStation 4 as well as PC. And you know, hopefully this game will be turn out to be amazing. As we get more details on this game, I will be sure to make a video about it and let you guys, or keep you guys in the loop. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. My name is Gamer LCD, and I'll see you next time.